Today we meet here to discuss another interpersonal communication skill, just like leadership and negotiation, that is teamwork. It is one of the three aspects of any organization that the growth of that organization is dependent directly upon. This is also one of the aspects that every person, every employee must have in their attitude so that they can grow individually. We will discuss about all these aspects in detail. However, during discussion, we will look at the definition of the team, what the team is actually, the types of team, how they function, what is the composition, how to make a team work, secrets of great teamwork, importance of teamwork at workplace, becoming a good team player. How to make a team work and secrets of great teamwork. These two slides are based on two of the very important and significant contribution in the field of organizational behavior on Harvard Business School campus, Boston. So we will look at all the aspects and discuss it. And in the end, we will try to go for some queries. Let's begin. The definition of a team says, it is a group of people working in unison to achieve singular goal to support core business value. We have already discussed what core business values are, right? So to support them, a team is very necessary. No, if you have a team, you have various perspectives, towards solution to a problem. If you are individual, it will be one way route to that problem, to solve that problem. But if you have a team, say four team members, so you will have four approaches to solve that problem, and somehow that combining all the four teamwork and all the four solutions, we can come up with a hybrid solution which can have lesser risk and greater contribution, solution at stake, right? So the composition of a team, that is the types. We have got mainly five types, although when we search on internet or when we go for reading in organizational behavior books, what we see that there are n number of teams. But broadly, we can divide them into five teams, five types. First one is functional team. Functional team belongs to one functional area or one functional department. Like if it is for HR, so all the employees or all the members of HR will constitute that particular functional team. If we go for marketing, if we go for sales, if we go for advertisement, if we go for finance, if we go for research and development, so everywhere we have got one functional team, belonging to one functional department. And then they try to solve problems on daily basis. Then there is another project or interworking team. As the work, term suggests, interworking team. So people or members or employees from different functional areas, from different functional departments, they come together, they constitute a team. And what the nature of that team is, they go for specialized products. they go for specialized projects, they go for specialized work, right? So that say you take out one member each from each functional team, and those members of those functional teams are experts one. So if you put together, go for a project, then troubleshooting team, these are trusted employees. These are not dependent on any particular department. These are trusted employees, right? So if say one organization is in negotiation with another organization for certain kind of work, and there is some problem that crops up, right? So what does this troubleshooting team does? They go for solving the problem, and that is independent of that negotiation process, right? So how does this get in function in the area? That the management or the topmost management of that particular organization puts in that trust in certain employees, and they employ them, they deploy them to solve that particular problem that has cropped up. So these, you can also say that these trusted employees are very close to the topmost management, right? Then self-managed teams, sometimes it happens that during transition period between two bosses, there is a time when there is no boss for that particular department, right? What does that mean? Does it mean that if there is no boss, the work should be stopped? No, the work goes on. And to make the work go on, every employee puts the hand up and says that I will go for this work, or they simply continue with their day-to-day work that they have been functioning. But there is no leader in it. There is no leader involved. So in that way, every individual or every employee becomes a leader in a particular way or two, right? And then that goes on. The hierarchy is almost not there, but every person or every employee becomes a potential leader. Then the last one is task force or emergency team. Employees with proven records of excellence to establish a new vertical, right? So if somebody has to go for establishing a new business, like Singapore, in Raffles University, Singapore, it wanted to go for establishing a new business in India. So it's shortlisted two of its best people available in that business and deputed them to Indian soil, Indian land. And then they partnered with certain people, certain other organization, and then they started a new educational business in India, right? Likewise, there are multiple examples. Like Adani Group went for establishing that Fortune brand that we have seen in oils, in refined oils, right? So that is a separate vertical, separate business that Adani Group has got into, right? So these new businesses are established by people who have got proven record of excellence. They are excellent people, and they have got a proven track record, right? Next two slides, we are going to look at the practical aspects of any team. And those two slides are heavily dependent on the two essays that I have given a reference in the end. First one is making a team work. based on PQM, process quality management at IBM. In late 80s, management at IBM, they came up with a unique idea of PQM, process quality management. Initially, it was limited to the top management, but then gradually it went down and it was a success even at hiring level. And looking at that, or taking a leaf of inspiration from that particular PQM, many other organizations, government and private, they all went in with the PQM. So we have to look at this PQM through two lenses. One, established with established employees at top level, and then a new making a new team. So those two, making a new team, when I'm saying it is about the hiring process, right? Beginning a new project. So first, look at from the point of view of top management. For example, the company or the organization needs to start a business, new business. So what will they do? All the top managers, say CEO, COO, CFO, vice presidents, board of directors, right? They come together, and once they come together, what happens that they come together for a particular goal, right? So first of the chain is of PQM, the chain is gather the team. So the topmost management allows or allots a particular work to a particular person or employee at the top, right? So they make a team, right? And once that team is formed, they sit together, right? Why do they need to sit together? They need to sit together to understand the mission of that particular organization, or not for our organization. They need to understand the mission for that work. And once that work is understood, right? Why do they want to do it? Right. So once that is done, that mission is stated, right? So they then break out that mission into smaller goals, and all those smaller goals, like finance goes to CFO, marketing goes to CEO, HR goes to COO, right? Like that. So chote chote goals banate hain us mission ka, and once that chote chote goals are understood by the team, right, they spell out and they tell us, or they tell the meeting or the members about what to expect from that particular that particular mission or that particular goal. Ek goal ke andar kya chahte hain, kya unka target hai, aur jo target hai wo kya us target se unko kya benefit hoga. To ek bari jab ye pura ho jata hai, ye jab aapas mein samajh lete hain, right, uske baad wo dekhte hain ki priority list kya hai, find out what matters most, fir wo priority list banate hain. Jab priority list banate hain, then they see that okay, first research and development needs to be looked at, then organizational context must be looked at, then if that is the case, then hiring is most important, right? Then production hoga, then production mein finance involve hoga. So then they go for priority list, making out the priority list, chalking out the priority list, And once that priority list is done, right, then smaller targets, even smaller targets, say weekly basis or fortnight basis or monthly basis, they set smaller targets. And once they set smaller targets, they go for following through it. Kitna achieved kiya? How much is achieved in that particular point of in that particular frame of time, right? So, ek baar jab ye pura ho jata hai, jab pura process ho jata hai, then we achieve a particular product, right? Acha, ye to ho gaya established. Ab ek new hiring mein dekhte hain. For example, Suprasteria is of course an IT giant, right? So it got on board one of the largest tourism company in the world, right? Thomas Cook. अब उसमें क्या करना है? उसमें ये करना है कि अब उनके divisions हैं. क्या divisions हैं Suprasteria के पास? उसका HR का division आया. Now एक बार ये HR का division आया, तो उनको एक team की जरूरत है, जो कि उस काम को करेगी. एक प्रोजेक्ट आ गया, अब उसको टीम की जरूरत है. सो दे विल गो फॉर गैदरिंग द टीम, राइट? गैदरिंग द टीम, वो उन्होंने अपना इंटरव्यू लिया, उनको लगा कि ये बंदा अच्छा है, ये इस काम को कर सकता है, तो उसको ले लिया. जब एक बार पूरी हायरिंग प्रोसेस खत्म हो गई, देन दे गॉट द होल इनटू ट्रेनिंग. क्यों ट्रेनिंग दिया? बिकॉज दैट इज न्यू हायरिंग, अ न्यू एंट्री, राइट? और एक बार जब न्यू हायरिंग हुई, राइट, तो उस न्यू हायरिंग में उनको मिशन बताया गया कि उनका एक्चुअल काम क्या है. और एक बार जब उनको काम बताया गया, ठीक, तो फिर उनसे पूछा गया कि अब बताइए आपके क्या क्या गोल्स हैं, इस काम से आप क्या अचीव करेंगे. एंड वंस दैट दैट वर्क इज दैट मिशन इज अचीव, ठीक है, उसको फिर प्रायोरिटाइज किया गया. ओके, सबसे पहले क्वेरी होगी, क्वेरी के बाद इंटरव्यूज होंगे, इंटरव्यूज के बाद उनका जो सैलरी ब्रेकअप है वो होगा, उसके बाद उनका रेफ चेक होगा, रेफ चेक के बाद उनको अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर्स इश्यू किए जाएंगे, अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर के बाद उनकी ज्वाइनिंग करवाई जाएगी, ज्वाइनिंग की पूरी फॉर्मेलिटी करवाई जाएगी, उनको पूरी नॉलेज दी जाएगी कि ये कैसे फंक्शन करेगा, राइट? सो सिटिंग इन इंडिया यू आर एक्चुअली गाइडिंग द होल टीम सिटिंग इन लंदन ओवर कॉल्स और ओवर इंटरनेट मेल्स और सम अदर टूल्स. Right. So, what did they do? They set the priority list. Priority list banaya. Usme fir team ko diya. Do teen teams baate. Ek ko team leader banaya. Aur uske baad uska follow through hua. Theek hai. So, this PQM works in two ways. One, establishing the top management team for establishing a new business. राइट? और एक बार जब न्यू बिजनेस आ गया, देन गेटिंग अ न्यू टीम. सो दिस वर्क्स बोथ वेज, फॉर टॉप मैनेजमेंट, फॉर द लोएस्ट टॉप मोस्ट मैनेजमेंट एंड द लोअर मोस्ट मैनेजमेंट. ये पूरा इसमें आता है, राइट? नेक्स्ट वन इज सीक्रेट्स ऑफ ग्रेट टीम वर्क. इसमें देर आर फोर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ दिस ग्रेट टीम वर्क. फर्स्ट वन इज अ कंपेलिंग डायरेक्शन. देर मस्ट बी अ कंपेलिंग डायरेक्शन फॉर द टीम टू वर्क. एंड वंस दैट डायरेक्शन इज गिवन टू पर्टिकुलर सेटअप, टू पर्टिकुलर सेटअप ऑफ द टीम, राइट? सो दैट कंपेलिंग डायरेक्शन इज one mission or one goal that the team is supposed to achieve. And once that team achieves it, right, that has the team working for it, not an individual working for it. Okay? Then a strong structure. The team also needs a very strong structure. If the structure is weak, the team will not be able to achieve 100% of its potential. Right? So they need a strong structure. That structure is defined by the organization. It varies from organization to organization. Alag alag hota hai, har jagah alag alag hota hai ye structure. Har jagah alag alag tarah ke boss hote hain, har jagah alag alag tarah ke employees hote hain, har jagah ke alag alag tarike ke rules and regulations hote hain. Right? But jo bhi rules hain, jo bhi boss hai, jo bhi employees hain, right? Everywhere that structure is followed. Their own structure is followed. कहीं भी थोड़ी सी की भी अगर कमी रहती है तो पूरा स्ट्रक्चर टूट जाता है. एंड वंस द होल स्ट्रक्चर गोज डाउन, क्रम्बल्स डाउन, द होल प्रोसेस क्रम्बल्स डाउन. एंड बिकॉज द होल प्रोसेस क्रम्बल्स डाउन, द टीम इज अनेबल टू रियलाइज 100% ऑफ इट्स पोटेंशियल. देन यू हैव गॉट अ सपोर्टिव कॉन्टेक्स्ट. व्हाई शुड द टीम वर्क, और व्हाई शुड आई वर्क इन अ टीम? Right, that what is the motivation behind it? So that motivation is a big factor here in a team, right? So time and again, the team leader needs to infuse that motivation in a team. How? That depends on the leader. We have already discussed that in leadership. Right, but time and again, that leader needs to make an inroad among the employees, among the team members, and then look at the team, motivate it, make it work. Aur jo motivation hota hai, wo biggest context hota hai, significant context hota hai. बहुत ही पावरफुल कॉन्टेक्स्ट होता है. इफ देयर इज नो मोटिवेशन, नथिंग विल डू. राइट? सो इफ आई एम सिटिंग हियर एंड अरेंजिंग अ क्लास, एंगेजिंग अ क्लास, राइट, व्हाट इज माय मोटिवेशन? आई नीड टू क्वेश्चन माय मोटिवेशन. राइट? एंड इफ आई एम मोटिवेटेड इनफ, आई विल ऑफ कोर्स गो फॉर 100, आई विल गिव माय 100% टू द क्लास. आई विल प्रिपेयर फॉर द क्लास. I'll search for the best material for the class. I will go for unbound time. Right? So that motivation must be there. If there is no motivation, what will I do? I'll simply sit back. I'll simply pass on a certain downloaded notes. Right? I'll simply go for doing nothing. Right? Strong motivation is needed for a team to excel, right? And because of that motivation, the team, and what is my team? My team is team of Faculty of Engineering and Technology. So I need to go into it. I need to support it. And I can support it only when I am motivated enough. If I am not motivated enough, I won't be able to support the cause. Then I must have a shared mindset. A team must have a kind of like-minded people, right? Like-minded employees. And with like-minded, I do not mean that a team needs to have cultural unity. No, I mean, a team does not need to have a cultural diversity. No, a team needs to have a cultural diversity, a linguistic diversity, religious diversity, right? All these diversities does not mean that I cannot have a shared mindset, right? I need to have a shared mindset. That shared mindset works on three fronts. Individual growth. What is the individual growth? Then collaborative growth. If I work with that person, the other person, what is the collaborative growth? And then organizational growth. So understand this in the context of we teachers at FOET. What is my growth? What is my personal growth? If I am preparing for say this slide for teamwork, this present PowerPoint presentation for teamwork, what is my personal growth? I go for a lot of reading. I go for a lot of exploration, right? Because of that exploration, because of that research, right? I get to know the dots in my mind. All those dots are queries, and I need to connect those dots. Once I research, I'm able to connect those dots. So that is my personal growth. Then collaborative growth. I work under, or I function under the Department of Applied Science and Humanities. So if I am working along with, say, Komudi ma'am, or Anupam sir, or DG sir, or Khushbu ma'am, or RP sir, right? So all these are collaborations. I am collaborating with them. And why do I collaborate with them? Only because the Department of Applied Science and Humanities has got one common goal, right, to achieve. So abhi jab webinar kiya tha to hum sab ek saath aakar ke humne usko goal ko divide kiya, jo PQM ka process hai wo kiya. Uske baad jab hum wapas aaye teamwork pe, तो हम सब ने एक काम लेकर के, एक छोटा छोटा काम लेकर के, और उस पर काम किया. इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि दूसरे के काम में हमने हेल्प नहीं की, या हमारे काम में दूसरे ने हेल्प नहीं की. हम सब ने एक दूसरे की हेल्प की, राइट? जब हमने एक दूसरे की हेल्प की, जब हमने एक दूसरे के साथ कोलैबोरेट किया, राइट, व्हाट डिड वी अचीव? वी अचीव्ड अ रीजनेबली सक्सेसफुल वेबिनार, राइट? So is it the success of Department of Applied Science and Humanities only, or it is a success story of Faculty of Engineering and Technology, or it is a success story of University of Lucknow? Hey, right. So pehle individual hai, smallest unit, then collaboration hai, a bigger unit. And then in the end, we have got organization, the biggest unit. Hey, so agar sare individuals, agar sare team members apna apna part nipate hain, apna apna part perform karte hain, to organizational goal achieve karna bahut easy hota hai, right? Then importance of teamwork at a place, at workplace. Right? It triggers creativity. Like I said earlier, during the definition, that if we have got two, three people in the team, right, and if there is any problem, so there are two, three solutions. If I am alone in the team, I'll have only one solution. Factor of risk. The probability of risk is high when the team size is small. Hey, when the team size is large, element of risk is less. Right? Makes employees happier. Leads to learning. Improved work pace. Jaldi jaldi kaam hota hai. Contributes to revenue generation, cultivates strong work relationships, team can self-monitor, team brings sense of accomplishment, induces accountability, increase the bus factor for a project. Bus factor hota hai ki har koi ek dusre se juda hua hai ek particular project ko lekar. हर कोई एक दूसरे पे डिपेंडेंट है. क्यों डिपेंडेंट है? क्योंकि सब डिपेंडेंट हैं प्रोजेक्ट पे. अगर प्रोजेक्ट होगा तब तो टीम एग्जिस्ट करेगी. अगर प्रोजेक्ट ही नहीं होगा तो टीम कैसे एग्जिस्ट करेगी? और अगर प्रोजेक्ट को रखना है तो टीम को एग्जिस्ट करना है, और अगर टीम को एग्जिस्ट करना है तो मिलके काम करना है. there is no other way. मतलब हम अगर ये सोचे कि what is the alternate way to teamwork? Actually, there is no alternate way to the teamwork. अगर एक टीम है तो सबको काम करना है. ये मजबूरी समझ लो, फोर्स समझ लो या कंपल्शन समझ लो, जो भी समझना है समझ लो, बट एक टीम को साथ में ही काम करना है. इसके अलावा उनके पास कोई रास्ता नहीं है. देयर इज नो ऑप्शन. हाउ डू वी बिकम अ गुड टीम प्लेयर? वी ऑलवेज हैव टू एक्सप्रेस आवर ओपिनियन. डजंट मैटर कि वो ओपिनियन कंसिडरेशन में आया या नहीं आया. डजंट मैटर कि वो ओपिनियन हंस के सबने हटा दिया. डजंट मैटर कि मेरे ओपिनियन हर बार एक्सेप्ट किए जाते हैं. डज नॉट मैटर. आई ऑलवेज नीड टू एक्सप्रेस माई ओपिनियन वेन देयर इज अ मैटर ऑफ टीम. क्योंकि हो सकता है, कभी भी हो सकता है, मैंने अगर मान लो कभी ओपिनियन नहीं दिया, मेरे मन में कुछ बात है, मेरे मन में कोई सॉल्यूशन है और मैंने नहीं दिया, सब लोगों ने दिया मैंने नहीं दिया, राइट? हो सकता है वो सॉल्यूशन जो मैंने सोचा हो वो अच्छा हो, राइट? सो इफ वी आर थिंकिंग वी मस्ट एक्सप्रेस, राइट? बी रेडी टू गेट गो टू द एक्स्ट्रा माइल. नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस दैट द वन हु प्रपोजेस द सॉल्यूशन has to take up that job, had to take up that particular thing. क्यों होता है ऐसा? लोग कहते हैं कि मैंने सजेशन दिया, अब ये काम मेरे ही सिर पे आ गया. काम सिर पे नहीं आता है, ये सिर्फ इसलिए किया जाता है because since you have thought of that solution, you have the best idea about that solution. For everybody else, that is second hand best. Hey, for you that is first hand best. That is why you should do that work. Then technology can always help. Make use of announcements. How you make use of announcements? Discuss remotely. आप WhatsApp पे, calls पे, हम लोग जैसे अभी Zoom पे कर रहे हैं, right? Keeps the entire team on the same page. जैसे अभी हम सारे लोग एक पेज पे हैं, बहुत सारे लोग एक पेज पे हैं, हम लोग एक दूसरे को सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं, राइट? सो टेक्नोलॉजी कैन ऑलवेज हेल्प टू बिकम अ गुड प्लेयर. दीज आर द टू एसेज दैट वी टॉक्ड अबाउट, वी डिस्कस्ड एज हाउ टू मेक अ टीम वर्क एंड the secrets of great teamwork, right? I have sent you these two essays. Please read them and see how best you can understand them now. I also believe that when I requested you all to read that once without considering the understanding, you must have read them. Now go and read them again so that you understand them better now. Thank you. Thank you.